Hello everyone, my name is Evelyn Bracho and I'm an industrial engineering senior student, and I'm here representing my team for Horizon Hoverboards. Before starting, I want to ask everyone here who can recognize this picture and who knows that it comes from Back to the Future. Also, also, who, whenever they saw it, decided that they wished that there was something out there like this that you can just buy and use it for yourself. Pretty fun, huh? That's where my inspiration came from. And as an engineering student, I decided to make my idea become real. And with the help of the College of Engineering and the Entrepreneurial Scene and Design Program, I was able to receive a grant to start building my prototypes and eventually fulfill my dream. So what is Horizon Hoverboards, or as I like to call it, the HH board? It is a fun recreational toy that tries to recreate the thrilling experience that other devices such as snowboarding, skateboards, or the wheel hoverboards can provide you. The way it works, it's really simple. It's just like a skateboard. You hop in, you thrust yourself, and you're gonna, instead of going with wheels, just having a smooth sensation along the floor. The manufacturing cost for this, if we, let's say a customer orders it with only one blower, it's $250 to build it. And depending on the weight, and if they need two blowers, the cost was $450. So what's, probably you have seen out there in the social medias that there are two companies trying to create kind of the same concept. And you will ask yourself, what is different from my, from their product and mine? The difference is two things. One, the price that I want to sell it for is just the fraction of the cost that my competitors are going to try to use. Second, since one of the boards uses magnets to levitate and the other one uses chemical reactions, they're very limited to only use it in specific surfaces. And my product will be able to be used, for example, on the back of your house, on your backyard, and this gives me more opportunity against them. For now, to begin, I just want to try to market the skateboarder riders here in the US, and it will be for people from the ages of 12 to 44 years old. As you can see on the pie chart, this accounts for the 71% of this target population. As I was doing this research about the numbers, I saw that this is a complete new market, so there is no real actual studies about this. And instead of just putting myself out there and getting money and just building 1,000 prototypes and trying to sell it and maybe fail at it, I decided to create a strategy. What I want to do is create at least 10 final prototypes so I can put, for example, a rental station where I can put my my product out there and customers can test it. And in that way, I can have a feedback. If it's really successful and I see that people like it, I can start selling it on the website that I already have. And it will be made by orders. So as soon as I get their money, I will be able to create their board. It takes 25 hours to create it and then just deliver it to them and have a happy customer service. And from there, the optimal thing will be to sell it to big retailers whenever we're recognized and everybody knows who we are. Here is a short video of the latest prototype working. As you can see, it really hovers by itself very lightly. And after that, we were trying to create the video with one of us riding as the previous prototype, but the blowers, one of them, it got into trouble and it's not working anymore. But yeah, what I want to plan and do after this, after graduation, is really get more grants and try to keep optimizing the current prototypes that I have and eventually have a final product that I can work with and try to get into this new market. And well, we want to remind you to let us lift you.